From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India has a spellbinding mosaic of culture, tradition, languages, and an extraordinary mingling civilization. Keeping its age-old culture maintained, today the country is taking huge strides in the path of development. Hello, I'm your host, Kyrim Zimik, and today in our episode of My India, we bring you some of the stories that will give a glimpse of our country's diversity. Indian classical dance forms have incredibly made their mark on international platforms and could now be seen in Hollywood concerts, movies, and songs. One of the most popular classical dance forms from India is Odissi, which has also been featured in a Michael Jackson music video. Showcasing the glory of Odissi dance, the Varsha Dance Festival was recently organized in Bhubaneswar City. India is home to numerous performing arts that vary according to different states, regions, and ethnicity. Odissi is a classical dance form that originated hundreds of years ago in the temples of the eastern state of Odisha. The dance form usually expresses religious stories and spiritual ideas. Celebrating the essence of Odissi dance, the 43rd edition of Varsha Dance Festival was recently organized in the state's capital, Bhubaneswar.
इनका मेन उद्देश्य यही है उड़ीसा के आर्ट एंड कल्चर म्यूजिक एंड डांस और जितने सब कलाएं हैं कलाकृति हैं उनको विश्व दरबार में प्रतिष्ठित करना और उसको विश्व दरबार में फैलाना और सबके सामने में उसको रखना और उसका जितना प्रभाव है उसको विस्तार करना ये फंक्शन का मूल उद्देश्य है और पिछले 43 ईयर्स में हम लोग यही काम करते रहे हैं और तीन फेस्टिवल के माध्यम से कर रहे हैं इसमें से वर्षा फेस्टिवल एक है
ऑर्गेनाइज्ड एट द रविंद्र मंडप द फेस्टिवल सो अ नंबर ऑफ डांसर्स परफॉर्मिंग ओडिसी डांस ऑन अ वैरायटी ऑफ रिलीजियस इवेंट्स एंड स्टोरीज वन ऑफ द डांस ग्रुप्स परफॉर्म द वर्सेस ऑफ तुलसीदास रामायण एंड कॉट द आईबॉल्स ऑफ द ऑडियंस ड्यू टू द मेस्मराइजिंग एक्सप्रेशंस एंड ग्रेसफुल डांस मूव्स Another dance group performed the Gotipa dance, a traditional dance form that originated in Puri, where boys dress up as girls. Spectators were mesmerized to see such colorful and graceful performances.
हम लोगों ने वहाँ पे एक अध्याय दिखाया है सीता स्वयंवर का और एक अध्याय दिखाया है राम और सीता जी के मैरिज का विवाह का और एक अध्याय दिखाया है रावण और श्री राम के युद्ध का तो ये तीन अध्याय हमने आज के रामायण के पूरा रामायण कवर करना इट इज़ अ वेरी वास्ट सब्जेक्ट बट जितना जो भी प्रसंग जो लोगों को हमेशा से सुनने से एक नया तरीके से अलग लगता है मतलब शुरू से ही जितना बार भी सुने नया लगता है तो वही प्रसंग हम लोग करने का प्रयास किए हैं और आई होप आप लोगों को अच्छा लगा हो
Along with the dance performances, an award ceremony named Chinta O Chetna was also organized at Raj Bhavan, Odisha. Many eminent personalities like Padma Shri awardee Kumkum Mohanty and police officer G. Hari Prasad were felicitated by the governor of the state, Ganeshi Lal. It is events like these that highlight the glory of Indian classical dances and showcase the country's culture at its best. India is a country where Sufism has not just flourished but has also become a way of integrating different religious communities. Even today, the teachings of these saints inform the lives of people and act as a guiding force for many. Today, we will take you to Dargah of Mubarak Khan Shahid in Gorakhpur city of Uttar Pradesh that has been acting as one such spot of religious togetherness.
Communal harmony is a required facet for maintaining peace and tranquility in a multicultural and diverse society like India. For this, The social fabric of the country has to be nurtured by connecting individuals from all spheres with one another. In Gorakhpur district of Uttar Pradesh, the Dargah of Mubarak Khan Shaheed is playing an active role in establishing this connection among various faiths.
हमको लगता है कि हिंदू अधिक आते होंगे. हकीकत यह है, कोई माने चाहे ना माने, मुस्लिम से अधिक हिंदू अधिक आते हैं. यहाँ पर श्रद्धा रहता है. कोई भी ऐसा दुकानदार जो है अधिकतर आता है यहाँ, माथा टेक के फिर दुकान खोलने आता है. हमारे खुद चाचा ही हैं, मैंने देखा है कि आएंगे द्वारी पर पैर धरेंगे, गोर धरेंगे, फिर निकल जाएंगे सीधे. अब बिना हम लोग इस रास्ते गुजरे सर माथा नीचे जा ही नहीं सकता, हमारा एक आदत बन गया.
Said to be around 1,000 years old, the Dargah holds a great significance as it welcomes people of all faiths to seek oneness with God. It is believed that the great Hindi poet Munshi Premchand used to visit this Dargah, and it has also inspired his popular work Eidgah. The holy site sees a huge rush of devotees on Thursday and during the Urs of the Saint, which is organized on the 26th, 27th and 28th of the Shawwal month of the Islamic calendar that coincides with the Gregorian month of October.
हमारे हिंदुस्तान में जितने भी धर्म रहते हैं, हिंदू, मुस्लिम, सिख, ईसाई, मैंने बौद्ध लोगों को भी यहाँ देखा, क्रिश्चियन को भी देखा है. एक सरदार जी, दो सरदार जी तो ऐसे हैं जो बिना नागा, बारिश हो, आंधी तूफान हो, नागा नहीं करते. हर धर्म के लोग आते हैं और यहाँ से फैजियाब होते हैं.
By giving out loud the message of peace and harmony, these Dargah of Sufi saints have been for long acting as a symbol of communal harmony.
Now a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
A batch of 136 Indian pilgrims left for Pakistan through the Atari border in northern Punjab state to celebrate the 313th birth anniversary of Hindu saint Sadguru Sant Shadaram Sahib at the Shadani Darbar Temple in Pakistan.
Sab darshan karenge और मौज करेंगे. टोटल 136 लोगों का जत्था है हमारा टोटल ये, और सभी धूमधाम से भी वहाँ पे हम खुशी खुशी जा रहे हैं.
The celebration will take place at the 300-year-old Shadaram Sahib Temple in Pakistan's Sindh province from December 4 to 15. The temple was founded by Shadaram Sahib in 1786, who was born in Lahore in 1708. Every year, thousands of Indian Sikh and Hindu pilgrims visit Pakistan to celebrate the religious festivals under the Pakistan-India Protocol on Visits to Religious Shrines of 1974. Indian singer Dhwani Bhanushali launched her song Mera Yaar in India's Western Mumbai city. Bhanushali, accompanied by Bollywood actor Aditya Seel, who also stars in the music video, danced to the song as they attended the launch event.
Mera Yaar, I think, is a very, very special song. Also, it's, as I was writing it, like, you know, I had the beat on, and then I started to think about this one crush that I had on a boy, my dad. And then I wrote about it.
Bhanushali has composed the song while her father has presented the song. Directed by Piyush Shazia and produced by Indian composer and music producer Abhijit Wagani, Mera Yaar has been sung by Bhanushali and Ash King.
Wedding is a costly affair in India, and if a girl doesn't have a father, it almost becomes impossible for her and her family to meet the expenses of marriage. Making this nuptial ceremony easier for these girls and setting a great example of harmony and brotherhood to the society, a businessman in Gujarat's Surat city hosts a mass wedding every year in which he funds wedding of more than 300 girls belonging to different faiths and communities. Let's have a look at this year's function that was a beautiful conglomeration of different religions under one roof.
Small lit-up huts, dazzling in colourful lights, with the whole area crowded with people. Having such a grand wedding would be a dream of every girl. making this dream a reality for thousands of girls. A Surat-based diamond merchant, Mahesh Savani, every year organizes a regal mass wedding ceremony where hundreds of fatherless girls are wedded off.
जो बेटियों का जो सपना है और ये बेटियों ने जो जिसका पापा ने उसने जो उसकी शादी के लिए सपना देखा है उसको सच करने के लिए हमारी ये कोशिश रही है। आज सुबह के सेशन में 65 बेटियां और शाम के सेशन में 70 बेटियों का शादी होने वाला है। इसमें आज के दिन में 3 मुस्लिम बेटियों का निकाह भी होने वाला है और 1 क्रिश्चियन बेटी की मैरिज होने वाला है और 1 पंजाबी बेटी का मैरिज है।
फैमिली मेंबर्स ऑफ द ब्राइड एंड ग्रूम वर प्रेजेंट एट द वेडिंग। They were seen mingling with each other as if they all are members of one large family. Savani has been organizing such mass weddings for the last 10 years. Besides doing all the arrangements, he also gives gifts and furniture to the couples to start their married life. This year, Savani funded the wedding of around 300 girls, in which 3 were Muslims, 1 Christian, and others were from different Hindu castes. No matter which religion or community they belong to, Savani gave his blessings to all the girls who to consider him as their father, setting a great example of religious unity to the society.
मेरे पापा के जाने के बाद मैंने सोचा नहीं था कि मेरी इतनी अच्छी शादी होगी और महेश पापा ने मेरी इतनी अच्छी शादी करी। उनका बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया, उनका बहुत बहुत जज़ाकअल्लाह। अल्लाह उनको इतना दे कि वो हम जैसी लड़कियों का हमेशा कराते हैं।
मुझे पता नहीं था कि मेरी शादी ऐसे होगी। महेश पापा ने बहुत अच्छी खरीदी करवाई, मेहंदी लगवाई, पार्लर में तैयार करवाया, बहुत अच्छा है। और हमेशा मैं ऐसा ही सोचूंगी कि हम जैसी छोकरियों के सर पे महेश पापा का हाथ रहे।
Savani is in true sense an epitome of love and communal harmony. His acts of generosity have not only reduced the worries of several families, but have also strengthened the thread of humanity and brotherhood that binds every citizen of our country with each other.
Next, we move on to Jammu and Kashmir, where house board owners are gearing up to welcome tourists during winter season. As the mention of Kashmir Valley remains incomplete without its colorful houseboats and shikaras, the owners are trying to leave no stone unturned in their preparation and are hopeful of good business this year. Have a look.
Representing the 800-year-old heritage of Kashmir, houseboats have always remained a major draw for tourists in the valley. Though they are found in several parts of the country, but the one in Srinagar are unique in style and making. They are mostly anchored on the banks of 2 beautiful lakes, Dal and Nagin and Jhelum River in the heart of Srinagar. Ranging from D-grade to deluxe, different categories of houseboats can be found at these sites, and many of them are only accessed by the shikaras. Tourists visiting Kashmir love to stay in houseboats, as here they can find complete peace and tranquility.
पहले हाउसबोट में रहने की सोचा था, तो मुझे लगा था यहाँ पे पानी है तो टेम्परेचर काफ़ी लो होगा इन कंपेरेटिव अगर कहीं बाहर रहते हैं क्या होटल लेके। लेकिन यहाँ पे जो एटमोसफेयर है, एक तो प्राइवेसी है नंबर वन, नंबर टू ठंड की वो टेम्परेचर डिफरेंस इतना ज़्यादा नहीं रहता है, फीलिंग कंफर्टेबल, और यहाँ का जो एम्बियंस है बहुत अच्छा है। खास करके मेरे को एक चीज़ जो मैं आपको बताऊँगा, यहाँ पे यहाँ की हॉस्पिटैलिटी बहुत अच्छे रहते हैं, जो यहाँ की केयर टेकर हैं दे आर टेकिंग केयर ऑफ एवरीथिंग। और सबसे बड़ी बात यह है खाने की, बाहर आप खाते हो ऑयली स्पाइसी होती है, यहाँ पर घर का खाना मिलती है, जैसे लगता है आप घर पर ही खाना खा रहे हो। एंड मैं यहाँ पर 2-3 दिन के लिए आया था, तो मैं देख रहा हूँ कि आई एम फीलिंग वेरी कम्फर्टेबल एंड एन्जॉयबल।
As of now, the winter tourism season is about to begin. Houseboats too are getting a few changes done. Owners are making the heating arrangements and the bedding too is being given a shift so as to provide a cozy atmosphere to the visitors. They say that they have done all the preparations to welcome tourists during this winter season.
हमें पता होता है सर विंटर में क्या क्या फैसिलिटी टूरिस्टों के लिए होना चाहिए? हम एक तो वुडन फायर रखते हैं सर, यहाँ पे बुखारी जिसको कहते हैं सर, ऊपर से हम रखते हैं सर हीटिंग ब्लैंकेट्स रखते हैं, गर्म पानी का वाटर बोटल्स देते हैं सर, 24 आवर्स गर्म पानी होता है, चालू होता है सर। और उसके बाद में अगर टूरिस्टों के साथ ज़्यादा कपड़ा नहीं होता है सर, तो हमें पता है सर यहाँ पे विंटर है कितनी सर्दी होती है सर, तो हम टूरिस्टों को हमारे पास जॉकेट्स होते हैं, फेदर के जॉकेट्स होते हैं, ब्लाई वो स्वीटर्स होते हैं, जब उनको गुलमर्ग पहलगाम जाना होता है हम उनको साथ में देते हैं सर।
जो भी टूरिस्ट आता है उनके लिए हम सफाई करके रखते हैं, या विंटर आने वाला है उसके लिए प्रिपेयर करके रखते हैं हम गर्म कपड़े, जो भी ब्लैंकेट है वगैरह है जो भी है गर्म के लिए विंटर के लिए वो हम रखते हैं। और टूरिस्ट को कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं होना चाहिए कि हाउस बोट में जो भी विंटर में सुविधा होनी चाहिए वो हो हम रखते हैं हाउस बोट में, बिल्कुल कोई कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं होती है टूरिस्ट को।
द फर्स्ट रिकॉर्डेड हाउस बोट इन कश्मीर वॉज रजिस्टर्ड इन द लेट 1880s. इट वॉज सेट टू बी बिल्ट for the Europeans by Pandit Narayan Bhan, popularly known as Nau Naran. At present, there are around 900 houseboats stationed along the banks of the most beautiful lakes of Kashmir. Considering the importance of houseboats, the Lieutenant Governor of Jammu and Kashmir, Manoj Sinha, announced a new policy this year that permits houseboats to undergo renovation. Moreover, the Union Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman, during her recent visit to Jammu and Kashmir, also announced a Shikara scheme under which credit of up to 15 lakh will be provided for the purchase and repair of Shikaras and houseboats.
At last, we bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings from around the world in our section of World in Focus.
Aeon Group in Japan has announced a scholarship for foreign students. The ceremony was held online along with a tree plantation program to promote environment conservation and harmonization with natural resources. Aeon One Person Club intends to strengthen ties and encourage social interaction among students. Students published a report on environment conservation and learned about Aeon's initiative. In addition, the tree plantation ceremony was broadcasted by live transmission and the students interacted with each other and asked questions about jobs and life in general. London has been lit up as the Christmas season approaches, with its landmarks wreathed in sparkling decorations. In Trafalgar Square, the Christmas tree sent to the UK by Norway as an annual gift following British support for Norway during the World War II takes centre stage next to a natively seen. London's shopping districts celebrate with themes including illuminated angels and butterflies, while more modern lights are seen outside Wembley Stadium and on London's cultural hub, the South Bank. Lightening of the Yokohama Harbour is celebrated through an event named Yoru no Yu, which is organized in the months of November and December. At least 30 spots in the city are lit up and are popped up with music. The Big Bridge Terminal for International Passenger Boat changes its colour of lights. This light and music show is the main attraction of the Yokohama city.
Yokohama の売りといいますと、港、夜の夜景が非常に評判なんですけども、まあ、これにさあの施設のカラーライトアップですとかサーチライトを加えまして、夜景そのものをですね、冬のイベントとしてダイナミックに音と光で演出するというのがですね、このイベントの醍醐味になっています。
The night view of Yokohama Sports City and the lightning event provides visitors with beautiful scenery and an experience of a lifetime. folk dancers paraded through the streets of Mexico City in elaborate costumes as part of a festive tradition that mocks Spanish conquistadors from colonial times. Known locally as chinelos, this dance reportedly dates back to the 19th century and sees locals imitate the elaborate dress and fair skin of Europeans at the time of Mexico's colonization.
Son magníficos, retratan exactamente la sociedad de clases que teníamos antes y que seguimos teniendo, pero que ya no nos permiten retomar este tipo de festividades tan hermosas. Los chinelos es parte de nuestra cultura y vale la pena rescatarla, y qué bueno que están haciendo esto.
Although the dance is normally performed during carnival season in Mexico, this parade is a modern take of the costume for the capital in order to revive the tradition. Thousands lined the city streets to catch a glimpse of the dancers, with different groups of performers coming from different delegations in Mexico City.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@ANIIN.com. I'm your host, Karim Zimik, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.